That is amazing destruction down there, Joplin. Very interesting to see how the rebuilding is going on. 68 degrees at 9 o'clock, partly cloudy skies. A beautiful evening in the metro. Winds are light. Skies are currently partly cloudy. And that's live Super Doppler 7 radar. Ground clutter out here. The radar had been showing a couple sprinkles in Monona and also Crawford County approaching Denison. Folks up there probably see a few clouds, but that precipitation not reaching the ground. Very quiet across the Midwest. Air is dry. Few showers from the panhandle into western Nebraska. Take a live look with our sky cam. It is a thing of beauty. Well, it was. Look at that. It slowed down. I mean, just a moment ago it was fine. Here's 480. Big backup now. You can see things have really slowed down even before you get to Interstate 80. It's always like that rush hour. Things can slow quickly. Otherwise, partly sunny skies. All right, I'm torn. I mean, this is one of the top 10 days of the year. The question is this it? Is this the top day? Because one of them's got to be. We had the comfortable dry air and 77 degrees for our high temperature. Of course, that is my favorite temperature here at KETV Channel 7. This might be it. Oh, there's nothing left to live for in the year if that's the case. Well, you never know. There might be more fantastic days on the way. 75 right now, a south breeze at 7, dew point 41. Oh, that is comfortable dry air. And 77 in Red Oak, also Plattsmouth this hour, and Fremont and York, 75 in Omaha. And really very pleasant all across the Midwest, though farther west, temperatures creeping up into the 80s in Valentine, North Platte. It's actually 90 right now in Scotts Bluff, Nebraska. High pressure nearby gave us the cool morning. You know, it was 41 this morning in Lincoln. Well, very cool. But high pressure edges away, so we pick up a little southeast breeze and partly cloudy skies overnight tonight and partly cloudy skies at daybreak, then mostly sunny during the day on Tuesday. It'll be a nice day, but you see these white lines. These are lines of equal pressure, what we call isobars. And when they're close together like that, it represents a change in pressure from high pressure to low pressure or vice versa. In this case, wind blows from high pressure to low pressure. And so we'll have a south wind warming things up, but also making it not as great of a day for outdoor activity. 68, 9 o'clock, partly cloudy skies. Wonderful evening. Later tonight, 55 for the low. Skies clear to partly cloudy tomorrow morning. Partly sunny, really pleasant, 60 with just a gentle southeast breeze, but the wind picks up pretty quickly tomorrow at 15 to 25 miles an hour, 82 degrees around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. That'll be the high for the day. And then it's 88 on the way for Wednesday, quite warm. Thursday, we see a 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms, and there is a biggie, a big holiday weekend coming up, a lot of folks, a lot of outdoor activities. And unfortunately, a front is going to get kind of caught in the area, giving us a chance of showers, maybe a thunderstorm Thursday, Friday, possibly early Saturday morning. Right now, it's kind of looking like things could dry out during Saturday and Sunday, and the front is possibly back in with a chance of showers or thunderstorms for Monday. So if we got 2 out of the 3 days dry, that would be pretty good, right?
I think today's the day.
This is it?
I do. This is it.
Wow.